Hey everyone, and welcome back to this Wikipedia. Today we're going to be looking at how to add OBD-II capabilities to your car that does not have an OBD-II port. So in this case, we've got the Turd Festiva from 1997. It does have OBD-I, but obviously that does not include the common OBD-II connector. So what we have instead is a diagnosis port. So what we've got here is two connectors. This main one up here is what we're going to be playing with. This one back here, if you short circuit some of these pins, you'll actually activate either the fuel pump or a different relay, which is useful for diagnosing, you know, things like fuel pressure issues and stuff like that. But this is what we're interested in today. And I'll just go through some of the pins here. So up here, we've got our constant 12 volt pin. Down here is our ground pin. And the only other two pins available are this one and this one here. And these are going to be our data pins. So I've done up a cheap little rig that I'll just grab now. So this is your fairly standard cheap eBay OBD-II connector. And the pins inside these connectors actually match up to whatever protocol your car's using. The only sort of common ones are this orange one here, which is our constant 12 volt, and this yellow one here, which is constant ground. All the other pins will either exist or not exist on your car, depending on which protocol it uses. In which case, the Ford and the Mazda vehicles from the 90s, a lot of them use the J1850 standard, which corresponds to these two pins that I've connected at the moment. So we'll plug this in and see how it works. So at the moment, you can see there's nothing going on with the adapter. I'll just turn the ignition on though. So as we can see with the ignition on, the OBD-II adapter's now got power, indicated by the first red light. Okay, and once we open up our Talk app for Android or whatever app you're using to read these codes, you'll see that all our lights begin flashing and we're now connected. So using this, you can do all the regular sort of stuff. You can scan for fault codes, which I think this car does actually have. So we'll look at those in the next video. And beyond that, you can get all your real-time information. So we've got coolant temperature, engine load, obviously RPMs, fuel trims, mass airflow sensor, intake air temp, oxygen sensors, vacuum, timing advance, speed and throttle position. So even though it seems like an old connector, there is actually a lot that this can tell you about your older vehicle. Now, as I said, these are pretty much found on 90s Mazdas and Fords. And some of them will have different pins available. So if you've got an adapter that looks the same, but with different pins, a quick Google should reveal which pins will put out your data signals. So that's about it for this video. Like I said, it's a pretty simple one. These adapters are available on eBay for very little money, but you want to make sure that you get something that looks like the older style. I also have a newer, more slimline one, and this one doesn't actually work with this car. And the other thing was these wires, I just had them lying around. I've just crimped little terminals just to make it easier to connect. The other thing that did confuse me when I looked online to get the pinouts for these things, they generally show the female connector. And because this is the male connector here, so all the pins are going to be reversed when you're looking at it. So make sure you get those pins the right way around. Like I said, the common power pin is on the very bottom right corner. So as long as that matches up, you should be able to figure out where the rest of your connections are going to be. The benefit of this is you can now read not only engine fault codes, but a whole bunch of other data from your older engine. So it's definitely going to make it a lot easier to diagnose any issues. I really hope this has helped you out. And if so, please give me a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit that little notification icon for more useful videos. Feel free to leave me a comment down below. Until next time, see you later. Turd and all its turdiness. OBD-I. Nah, fuck. Today we're going to be adding OBD-II to our pre-OBD-II vehicle. No, that's dumb too. But what we're more interested in is these pins up here. So that's about it for this one. As I said, it's going to be a pretty... fuck.